Hi, thanks for joining us today. I'm going to be presenting the migratory bird hunting seasons that were approved by the Natural Resource Board earlier this morning. Again, I want to highlight and thank everybody that was part of the public involvement process. This year, we really ramped up our efforts and how we used the public input and how we asked for public input from waterfowl hunters. For example, we sent out well over 270,000 emails to everybody across the state. We also did a couple of Facebook posts and Facebook live video. And again, using that as a new method to try and reach out to people to have them inform them on our process and what our proposals were. And through Facebook Live and Facebook posts, we reached out to over 51,000 people, and 15,000 people directly watched our last Facebook post. So thank you again for being part of this process. We also, based on that, all of our extra effort that we did to try and grab as much input as possible, we saw a 400% increase in public input gathered from you guys during this process compared to last year. And also, when I do my trip around the state at our public hearings, we had double the attendance. So again, I thank you all for making the time to either come out or provide public comments. So again, based on all the information that we have available, if you look at the link that's included below, we have included on our webpage a detailed description of how all the public input shook out during the process, as well as I'm going to be letting you guys know that there's been some significant changes for the waterfowl, both the duck and the goose season structures compared to years in the past. For example, the first one is that it was approved to eliminate the Horicon Canada Goose Management Zone. So again, this is a historical zone, it's a lot of tradition. However, I will be presenting a little bit later in this why we did that. It was based on social issues, it was based on biological issues. So again, I'll touch base on that a little bit later. Secondly, we are going to be increasing the Canada goose bag limit from 2 geese per day to 3 geese per day. And again, that decision was based on, we looked at an analysis to say where are the Canada geese coming from that we harvest. And in years past, we were primarily focused on those Ontario migrating birds that came into the state and less focused on our own birds. However, as of the most recent, which was 2015, it showed that the majority of our harvest was occurring on our local birds and less so on our Ontario migrants. To the extent that we feel that we're comfortable in suggesting, or at least trying for this year, increasing the bag limit to Canada geese, and we will monitor how that's going to impact populations and harvest going into the future and see if we can maintain having a 3 goose per day bag limit. Another one for Canada goose seasons is in the southern zone. We are going to have a second split, so a second closure in the zone. We've been able to do this per federal regulation for quite some time, however, we've never taken advantage of it. And what this does is we will, for the second split, we'll be closing the Canada goose season with the duck season in the south zone and closing it for 13 days and then reopening it up on December 16th and running it through Christmas and New Year's. And again, biologically, it has very little impact. We know that 90% of the Canada goose harvest occurs prior to November 25th. So if we're changing days around in December and moving them later in December, it's not gonna really have an impact on harvest. But there is additional opportunity for kids coming home from school, coming home from college, or people are around for the holidays, and there's just additional opportunity in the southern part of the state to take advantage of Canada geese later. Another big change is that we are going to have the North Duck Zone starting a week later than we have in the past. Again, this was based on public input that we received over the past several years. Last year, we were pretty close based on public input to doing so, but we decided that we wanted to monitor it, see if it was going to be similar for 2018. And again, in 2018, public input was very much in favor of doing so, as well as the key conservation and hunting groups all showed indications of favor for changing the waterfowl season in the north zone to a week later. So what this means is that we will have a statewide opener in the north, south, and Mississippi River zone on Saturday, September 29th. Additionally, we are going to have a early teal season. This was, again, our first year based after the experiment of the early teal season. We had a committee that looked at all of the information. We asked questions on our waterfowl hunter survey, and we took it out for public comment. And it came out that yes, we do want to have a teal season in Wisconsin, and September 1st through September 7th was the decision for having a teal season. However, we did do some changes to the shooting hours, which, if you recall, the opening day shooting hours in the teal season was 9 a.m. during the experiment. However, we are going to change that to sunrise to be consistent with how we open up things during the regular season. We no longer open up at 9 a.m. during the regular season on opening day, as well as the closing shooting hours. Rather than 7 p.m., we're going to make it consistent with morning dove and Canada geese and closing it at sunset. Lastly, per federal regulation or per federal frameworks and harvest strategies, the pintail population increased in 2017 to a level that we could increase the pintail bag limit from one, which was in 2017, to two for this year. Everything else, again, you can find all of these season frameworks on the link that we have included. It's on our waterfowl webpage. You can go to the DNR webpage and search waterfowl, and it'll be right up there on the top. Or again, as I said, click on the link here and you can look at everything that we have approved by the Natural Resource Board. Again, just the highlights, these are some of the population trends that we've been seeing at a continental level. We are at record highs. This was the fifth highest on record for population estimates at a continental level. Wisconsin, it appears that we've leveled out over the past decade or so. For Canada geese, these are the main populations that we monitor when we set our Canada goose seasons and bag limits. As you can see in Wisconsin, which is the graph over here, that we've had a long-term increase in our local giant population, and it seems that we've stabilized or leveled out over the past decade or so. However, for the Mississippi flyway giant population, so the local giant population for the Mississippi flyway, which is in 14 states and three Canadian provinces, that population is at an all-time record high. We set a record last year. And the other population is the Ontario migrating population. We've seen a long-term decline on their population. However, it does appear that we've stabled out over the past 8 to 10 years. I did want to provide a little bit of additional information on our decision for eliminating the Horicon zone, because I do recognize that this is a tradition and it's going to be a big change for people in this area of the world. We had seen a 90% decline in goose harvest in the Horicon zone since 1999, and a 75% decline in hunter participation in the Horicon zone during that same time period. We wanted to figure out how come that was occurring. What we did is, me and my assistant Trent, we did a band analysis to look at where the Ontario birds that are migrating through into Wisconsin in the Horicon zone, well, how has that percentage changed over time and how has that harvest changed over time? So in 1980, 54% of all the Canada geese shot in the Horicon zone were Ontario migrants. In 1990, that was 43%. In 2019, and as of 2010, only 13% of the Canada geese shot the Horicon zone were what we would have considered Ontario migrants, which was the sole purpose of the Horicon zone. Again, why are we seeing that? What this is a band analysis to say where the band recovery is occurring on these birds. If you look, the ones with the blue dots here represent locations, and the other figure on the right represents what concentration, so how much of those band recovers and where they're occurring. So as you can see, in 1980, we were very heavily focused in the Horicon zone. That's where most of the recovers were happening. Similarly, in 1990, again, most of it was happening in the Horicon zone, but you can already start to see a spread out of these recoveries. This is 2000, and this is 2010. So what this does is show us that we have seen a much larger spread out and harvest occurring on these Ontario migrants rather than just in the Horicon zone. And again, what we've been seeing is in the 1970s and 80s, the only Canada goose that was happening in the state of Wisconsin was in Horicon. And the Ontario migrants would come through and stop at Horicon because that's where they all were. However, now when a goose migrates into the state, they can see them in every single county, and what's happening is our local birds are decoying these birds away from Horicon. So again, based on all of this information, we proposed, well, can we eliminate the Horicon zone? We asked the question in our waterfowl hunter survey, and that came back that 95% of respondents said yes, we could eliminate the Horicon zone, and we had a greater than 95% response when we took it out for public hearings and public comment to eliminate the Horicon zone. So again, both biologically and socially, it does appear that we are able to eliminate the Horicon zone, and that's what the Natural Resource Board approved today. Again, I want to sincerely thank everybody that has been part of this process. We are going to continue to do better to try and make ways that we can get public input from you a little bit easier than we have even this year. And again, we plan on doing these Facebook Live videos and interacting with you guys on this kind of media, because I do believe that it has absolutely helped out. So again, thank you very much.